Brett wanted clarification on how titles and keyframes work in Final Cut Pro 10. Press the button with the T on it to show the title browser. Motion 5 was used to create these titles. When you right-click or control-click on a title, you'll be able to open a copy of it into Motion. Without going into Motion, you can add any of these titles to your project by dragging one onto a clip in the timeline. However, Motion is very useful when you need to modify a title. Double-click the middle title to add it to the current location of the playhead. On the timeline, drag the title to move it in time, or use the edges to lengthen or shorten the title. This middle title is very simple. Double-click it in the viewer to change the text. The circle in the center of the title can be used to reposition the title anywhere on screen. Open the inspector with Command 4. There are four tabs at the top. The Info tab is used to label the selected title. Video tab allows for changes similar to the ones that can be made to video clips, including color correction, positioning, and setting blend modes. The Text tab includes font options, color, outlines, and even the ability to add a glow or drop shadow. Spend a little bit of time getting used to these options, and use the presets at the top to get an idea of what can be created. The final tab is the title tab, and this is one of the most important for animation. When creating a title in Motion, you can choose to publish parameters such as font, color, and even builds or animations. For this title, the font is what I'm looking for, but I'd like to have the letters spread apart at the start and then slowly come together over time. This can be accomplished by adding keyframes to the tracking parameter. This parameter is not currently published, so here is how I will change that. Right or control click on the middle title, and then choose Open a Copy in Motion. Motion can be purchased from the Mac App Store for $49. I'll select the name layer, and then go to the tracking parameter in the inspector. To the right, there is a menu with a publish choice. I'll choose this for both text layers. Save the project, and then return to Final Cut. Add the middle copy title to the timeline, and in the inspector, tracking is now an option. To animate the letters, they have to start spread apart, which would be a higher tracking number. Then, over time, lower the number to bring the letters together. When working with keyframes, it is very important to know where your playhead is on the timeline, because that is the moment where the keyframe is going to be added. For this example, the text will start moving right away, so I'll hit the up arrow on my keyboard to move the playhead to the start. If there is a built-in, it can help to disable it while you are adding keyframes. With the tracking numbers raised, push the Add Keyframe button on the right. The orange color lets you know that a keyframe is added. Next, move the playhead to the point at which you want the text to start moving. Adjust the tracking and a keyframe is added automatically. Play back the project and you should see the text animating. Modifying and expanding the animation is easy. Just use the buttons to the left or right of the keyframe button to navigate to a specific keyframe. You can adjust the tracking level at any moment in time or delete a keyframe completely. Remember that you can have as many keyframes as you need. If you want the speed of the tracking to go faster or slower, for example, just add a few more keyframes. If you want to start over, just push the triangle and choose Reset Parameter. Keyframes can also be viewed in the timeline using the menu at the left of the clip name. This can be helpful to visualize where the keyframes are relative to time. I hope this gives you a better idea of how keyframes and titles are created in Final Cut Pro 10.